Welcome back to the channel where we continue on in Power BI, and today we're going to take a look at some chart formatting. What used to be called in Power BI was an analytics pane, and that changed in 2022. It is now called a reference line, and we're going to show you how to use the reference line to add a average line, a minimum line, a maximum line. It can be helpful for users of the report that need a baseline for what those numbers represent. So we're going to make a bar chart and then add an average line, a minimum line, and a max line, and show you some of the other reference line options in Power BI. Let's go to Power BI. Back in Power BI, and we are going to add a reference line to a bar chart. And sometimes when your users are looking at these charts, some of the lines, if they are not as familiar with the data as the person creating the report is, some of the numbers that come up in context don't mean as much. So one of the things you may want to add is a reference line for the max, the minimum, and the average. So we're going to start off by building a bar chart, and we're going to make this nice and big. We're going to add to the y-axis, we're going to add from the calendar table, we're going to add the year. And then to the x-axis, we're going to add the total view. So what that's going to allow us to see is by year, the total view. So to make this a little bit more of a readable chart, we're going to do a little bit of formatting. We're going to leave the size the same. For now, we're going to change the title to just total views by year. We'll leave that the same. And let's start working on the bars. We will update the color, change that to more of a gray. And then also for the x-axis, we are going to change this on the values to thousands. That will allow us to see the views a little bit more comfortably. And at this point, we're ready to add the reference lines. Data visualizations, near the bottom, you have what's called a reference line. And you can add a line. And if we want to change the name of this, we can go max. And then the type is where you choose to add in your reference lines. You can have a constant line, min, max, average, median, percentile. So we are going to add in a max line. And now you get your formatting options. You can make the color change. So for this one, we'll use kind of a brighter blue. And rather than a dashed line, you could make that a solid line. So the maximum line is the 2022 total views. Then you can add a second line. And for this one, we will add the minimum. And the type is going to be a minimum line. And same thing there, we will add in a dark purple color. And we'll leave that dashed. So the minimum was in 2020, the first year of the channel. And now we have a max line in blue. We have a min line, which is dashed. And now we can start to add another line. So this one for, we will use an average. And really what you're doing with these reference points is adding in some context to the data. So when you're looking at 2023, we want to see where that fits in, and we're going to use this again as a dotted line. So now we've got a dash, a dotted, we've got a solid line, but when you start to look at your minimum is 2020, for the viewer, they can quickly see some context and point of reference to this chart. So you can add these in front. You can have it be behind. I think more normally, I like it when it's kind of in front. It sticks out a little bit more. If you wanted to add some data labels, you could add in some of those. So you can start to see
for 2023, your 333,000. If we wanted to position that differently, we could. But what really the reference points does is add some context to that chart. So again, you can add these to bar charts, you can add these to column charts, and the reference point used to be the analytics pane, but now in the formatting on the chart, they're located near the bottom and it's called the reference. And that is where you start to add in the reference line. We currently have an average, a minimum, a maximum, and the different types are a constant. You could add in a median, or you could add in a percentile line to use for your reference measures. So make sure to use these. Take a look at these. Another feature to make your charts stand out a little bit more. It allows you to... Now, the one thing is you don't want to add too many of these. So I would say overall, if we were really using this, we would probably get rid of the average and maybe use the maximum and the minimum to kind of make them stick out a little bit more. But the reference lines can be very helpful for a statistical function when you want to kind of reference what that current year number is to take a look at the overall context of those 4 years. You've got the minimum, you've got the maximum, and you kind of see where 2023 fits in for total views on this chart. So that is a look at adding a reference point in Power BI. So that is how you add a reference line in Power BI. You can add it to your different charts. Remember, you do not want to have too many reference lines, so choose the one that will give the most context for the end user, whether it's average, minimum, maximum, maybe a percentile. Again, a good Power BI report, you're thinking of the end user, who is the audience for, and you're really doing this in the final stage of your Power BI workflow. This is after you've added all your charts, you've set up your reports, then you want to start to optimize your report so that the end user can get the most use out of the charts and visualizations that you have created.